Well, here we are back in Liverpool. Lovely day. We're at the CF Mott College of Higher Education, and they've asked for a couple of physical jerks to start with. So here we are, Wilf and me. Oh, Wilf and I, sorry. Higher education. So for the next half hour, we're going to entertain you, starting with us two and Jim.
Jim?
Yeah, gymnastics from this mob here. A big clap. Back on the Mersey, where they've got ferries at the bottom of their garden. We're all here. What school are you from?
St. Cyril!
Nice one, St. Cyril. Everybody's here. As I said, we've got Dana, we've got the incredible Wilfred Makepeace London, and we've got Parrot. Now, I want to tell you a story. Wrong fella. But, oh, have a seat, because I want you to be relaxed. I'm going to tell you a story anyway. Just so you... make sure you're listening. Say it back after me.
Once a well-trained hare.
Once a well-trained hare.
And the tortoise had a race.
And the tortoise had a race.
And the difference in the pair.
And the difference in the pair.
Was their different pace. Life is just the same.
Would you please explain?
There are many ways to go.
Shovels.
Well, you can be pushing and shoving and kicking and thumping and treading on people you're passing, or you can proceed dead slow. But can I just convey the thing I'm trying to say? You've got to go your own way, but there is something can maybe make the day. Put your best foot forward. Everywhere you go, you know your confidence will carry you through. Put your best foot forward. Everyone will know you do your best in everything that you do. Sing with me. Putting your best foot forward could create the style. So where's the smile? Come on, create the style. Putting your best foot forward. You could lead the field and be a real delightful character too.
Your nose
to the grindstone.
Your shoulder
to the wheel. Your back against the wall, cause it might fall around your heels and round your knees and round your feet. Put your best foot forward. Maybe who can say you'll win the day? Well, who can say? Put your best foot forward. There could be the prize before your eyes, to your surprise, and it's true.
How would you advise of the kids of size?
How would I advise of the kid your size? It is wise, I'd say, it is wise
to put your best foot forward in every single thing that you do. To do the best you can do. Ask for my advice and I'll turn to you. That's one. That's two.
best foot forward.
Your best foot forward.
Your best foot forward.
Your best foot forward.
In every single thing that you do.
Thank you. Before we go any further, I'd like you just to have a look at that beautiful backdrop there. That's actually the Liver Building, and it's a composite photographic blow-up of three pictures, little tiny pictures done by three of the youngsters in this school. It's good, isn't it? Very good. You've all heard of the Liver Bird, right?
Yeah.
Well, I found out this morning there is no such bird. Apparently the word Liver is the local dialect, or was the local dialect, for a cormorant. And the way that came to be associated with the city, let me show you this. This is the original grant of arms for the city of Liverpool. And apparently this is the first time that that bird ever appeared on the city of Liverpool coat of arms. This is now called the Liver Bird. And this was granted in 1797. This can be seen in the city of Liverpool libraries. You can go and see this is the real document. This isn't a copy of it. Look at the beautiful lettering. It's all hand done by some fellow way back in 1797. Give him a clap, a little clap. Good job done. Oh, keep that applause going for our special guest. I think it's Ken Dodd. I think.
Knick-knocky, knick-knock, knicky-knocky moo. What a wonderful day. What a wonderful day, Mrs. for running against the Joseph Williams School and shouting, "Stay settled!" It's how tickled I am. How tickled I am. You have been tickled, Mrs. How tickled I am to introduce to you the Tattabladius Turner!
Lovely. Have a seat. Have a rest. You did very well there, dancing beautifully. Thanks, Dana. We're going from the pop music of today, and we're going to have a listen to some of the popular music of many years ago. And we've got two youngsters here playing flute, Maureen and James, and they're going to play for us the Allegretto by Mozart. Listen to this. Thank you. Yes, lovely. Good one, good one. If you hop on a ferry, go down the Mersey, cross a little bit of water, you get to the Isle of Man. If you get to the town of Ramsey, you may well meet this fella. He's a tailor, and he has a pet mouse. Now, these are photographic blow-ups from drawings done by these youngsters, little tiny drawings, and they're going to form the basis of the animation for this next song. Oh, by the way, if you want to join in the chorus, you're perfectly welcome. Let's do it.
There was a tailor had a mouse. They lived together in one house. The tailor thought his mouse was ill. So he gave him part of a big blue pill. The tailor thought his mouse would die. So he made a mouse and kidney pie. The mouse jumped out. The tailor chased him all about. The mouse cried out, but we were friends.
When hunger starts, then friendship ends.
Right up the wall and round the bend. The mouse cried, that's the bitter end. And it was hard to look.
Along the country waysides, you hear the sound of Daisy the old cow waiting for milking time. Moo! Moo! While overhead flies our old friend the feather-chested coat hanger. And on a nearby branch sits a raspberry-blown chaffinch. And here we have the rarest of old birds before you need to know about. Birds are beating and baffling. Both birds make peace. Love.
Wilfred, tell us a little bit about bird baiting and baffling. I understand it's all to do with pestilential birds. Is that right?
That's right, yes. This, in actual fact, is a model. Should I get financial support, I will build full-size ones.
Understood.
This one is the humane pigeon catcher.
How does it work?
Well, at the front, you see, we have the little berries,
yes,
right?
Yes, yes.
The pigeon flies down to eat the berries, mm. And this snapshot like that, catching the pigeon humanely.
I see. This one?
This one is the non-humane pigeon catcher. On this one, we have a little worm at the front. When the pigeon comes down, you press the lever like that.
Oh!
Which considerably distresses the bird.
I see. I see you've also got the protection from his friends up there flying about.
Yes. Very good.
Now this one is to use on cloudy days. It's called a sneaky pigeon catcher. Because the pigeon flies past and it thinks, what's the sun doing down there? It flies down to have a look and it sits on this perch. And when it does, these two heavy duty clouds go like that and squash the bird. So it's nice and flat. So you can put it in a folder or on a book.
Oh, books like what? Penguin or Puffin?
That's good. Yeah, very good, that. Very good.
This one is for housewives, you see. It's the vulture clothes peg. And the idea of this is that you pin all your washing with these little vultures along. And any other birds that are flying past think, I'm not going down there to tackle those nasty beasts. So they keep away from your washing.
It's very good, isn't it? Good little crack there go well for that one.
Now this one.
Yeah.
You know how little birds come down and they pick the tops off your milk bottles? This is to prevent them doing it. Now, should it not work, right, we have another device on it. You notice the top is like a large milk bottle.
Yes.
So if you get a really brave bird comes down and lands on there, like this bird here, it lands on the top like that. And as it goes down, it thinks nothing's wrong because it thinks these lupins are just growing. In actual fact, they're laser lupins. And when they detonate, they go like so.
Tell me, what's this one?
Now, this one...
Quiet, please.
This one is called the Overkill Duck Gun. And to make it look realistic, I've also got this flapping device, you see, so the wings flap like so. And the little ducks follow it. And when you've got lots of little ducks following it, you light the fuse, like so. See, it's fitted with a silencer. Now this one is the ultimate device for baffling and frightening birds. You'll note that it's got rockets round it, which detonate. Like...
Character, isn't he? Hello. I asked Alec at the last minute to paste the paper down on this board today, and the glue's still a bit wet. You don't mind that? A bit of pattern on there, do you? No. Good one. Good one. Let's get on with it. This is an Australian painting we're doing today. Mind your head, Christine, because... Hello. I've only used the wrong blessed paint. I've used water instead. Swap you. I'll give you that for that. What an idiot. That's better. Better. Mind your head, Christine. Grief, girl. It's water and paint and stuff goes everywhere. That's better. Oh, mind your leg. Keep your head back round the corner, Christine. We'll get you, love. A bit more glue through there. Isn't it exciting? Are you enjoying it so far? Be careful, Rolf. More haste, less speed, as they say. Yes, slow down, Rolf. I've got to get through a lot of... Now, what I'm doing is I'm painting a big sort of a hill here. Put a bit more blue on there, perhaps a little tree up there like that. Another one up there. Look out, Christine, I'll get you. In the north of Australia, the Aborigines picture the sun as a young goddess with skirts of light fluttering about her. So when she gets up in the morning, I think I'll take a bit of that and we'll do some darker trees there. When the sun gets up in the morning, they imagine that these skirts of light cover more and more of the surrounding countryside, and they imagine that it brings back the warmth and the life to the earth. It's a very, very ancient type of tree. It's called the black boy. It's a really old, old primeval tree, and it has a big seed pod which stands up there and looks like a bunch of spears. I need that chair, I think, Joe. A few little branches and leaves there like that. It's going well so far. You enjoying it?
Yeah.
That's good. Put a bit of a shadow running down the hill there past these trees. And over here, we'll do a young Aboriginal boy. And imagine he's standing up there waiting for the sun to rise. There's his hand there. And he's clutching some spears. And we'll do... Perhaps his lips there in a big forehead. They've got huge foreheads, the Aboriginals in Australia. Massive hair out there like that. Holy, look at that face. That's good. I'll put some black hair on him.
That's good, just enough to leave his ears showing out there like that bit of shadow there, his eyes. Does that look like a face there? Yeah, thank goodness you're here. I would have probably panicked otherwise. Now, we put the back of his elbow there like that, a little bit there. And we'll put some spears up there. Really tall spears. Boom, boom, down there to the ground. A couple of spears. Does that work? Bit of shadow around his hand here, a little bit of shadow.
Shall we put some trousers on him? Yes, you're all embarrassed, yes. Give him some trousers. What a good idea. Wish I'd thought of that earlier.
There you go. Hang on to that, my dear.
Mention there's a little bit of light brown behind there, a little bit of reflected light behind the back there, a little bit on his arm there. Now, if you can imagine the sun's just rising, I'll pinch that chair, and we'll have the sun, first of all, rising and hitting the tips of his spears, so the sunlight is just coming down there. Brilliant sunlight, just on the edge of his spears, and on his forehead there, just on his nose, on his cheekbones, on his top lip there, like that. A little bit on his neck there, bit on his front of his arms. Hey, how's that? That's good, some on that tree. There's a blessed beetle there, still asleep from the last painting we did a couple of weeks ago. Oh, I don't know. Is that enough?
Yes.
You fellas on the didgeridoo, just get ready now. Harry, before we go, I wonder if you could change the lighting. Imagine it's just before dawn. We're waiting for the sun to rise.
Oh, that's good. Right, hit the didgeridoos.
Ready for the beating sticks? I'll tell you when.
Sunrise, she bring in the morning. Sunrise, bring in the morning. Fluttering the skirts all round. Sunrise, she come with the dawning. Sunrise, come with the dawning. Spreading all the light all around. Sunrise, come with the dawning. Sunrise, she come every day. Sunrise, bring in the morning. Sunrise, every day. She drive away the darkness. Every day, drive away the darkness. Bringing back the warmth to the ground. Sunrise, oh, spreading all the light all around. Sunrise, bring in the morning. Sunrise, bring in the morning. Sunrise, bring in the morning. Spreading all the light all around.
Yourselves a clap, you're marvellous, thank you. Just realised, my guy that I painted, he was all leaning forward, he'd fall over if he didn't have the spears there. Would never do for Dana, this one.
Together I'm coming. Thank you, Dana. The most popular song from the audience point of view in our last series last year was this next one. Two bars in, fellas. A one, two, two, two.
You live your life, you do your thing, you take it as it comes, until you strike adversity and fingers turn to thumbs. I know advice is hard to take, but take a tip from me. When circumstances get you down, the place for you to be's a apple tree. Fiddly, fiddly, apple tree. That's the place, oh, that's the place for me. You can sit there night and day, and there's no parking fines to pay. A apple tree, fiddly, fiddly, apple tree. The other day I took me girl to stroll around the farm. A bull went mad and smashed the gate as we stood arm in arm. She started screaming, help me, save me, I don't want to die. I didn't run or panic, lads. Oh, where was I? Apple tree, diddly, diddly, apple tree. That's the place. When the bull came roaring round, like a man I stood me ground. Apple tree, diddly, diddly, apple tree. Now I'm the sort of fella who is not too sure of zoos. I'd rather visit a game farm where wild animals wander loose. Cause I'm not scared of lion, tiger, pygmy, mouse or flea.
Hang on a minute. What is it, Paul?
There's a spider on your knee!
Where you are, and you're still stuck in the car. Apple tree, fiddly, fiddly, apple tree. And a bloomin' great giraffe has licked the window for a laugh. Apple tree, fiddly, fiddly, apple tree. Look out, here comes a rhinoceros, and he plans on joining us. Apple tree, fiddly, fiddly, apple tree.
There's the show. Thanks to Parrot. Thanks, lads. And thank you to the amazing Wilfred Lunn. And thanks to the lovely Dana.
Dana, where are we next week?
Well, we're going back to Norwich again.
That's good. There's lovely restaurants in it. I wonder if I could perhaps take you to dinner, Dana.
Really?
What does that remind me of? Dinner, Dana, dinner, Dana, dinner, Dana, dinner, Dana.
Okay, see you next week then.